for the fake police that we talk about in our press conference, because we alerted the world that we had reports that some fake policemen and soldiers were being prepared to disrupt the elections in areas that APC was likely to lose. So we're beginning to see the first evidence in Kokona, and hope that what is going on there will not go out of hand. We want to thank the people of Basa for being courageous enough to stop these soldiers from hijacking their own electoral materials. And we call on the state government to withdraw these machineries. We are told that they are camped somewhere in Wamba, they are camped in an uncompleted building somewhere in Latvia. They are also camped in each of these territorial districts to disrupt the elections in places. We also told that there are inadequate materials in Akwanga local government. There are complaints we have received that in some polling units they took away something like 200 ballot papers from there, making them incomplete. We are told that in KP today, the turnout is very low, and people say they are not going to come because some people have completed their voting already, indicating that there has been most likely some massive ballot box stopping and tongue printing going on in KP. Because why is it that the people are not coming out? And they are saying that there was no need to come out because their vote had already gone forward. How? Who has voted on their behalf? For example, these are complaints we are receiving from our agents, you know, who are spread all over Nigeria State at the moment. We are also very, very worried because yesterday, some ballot boxes were arrested in Latvia. We don't know why the security are keeping it silent. We are aware from our reports that some ballot papers, some ballot boxes were arrested yesterday by some by the security, by the police in Latvia. I'm told that they don't want to report the story because they felt that it might alarm the rest of the political community about the fact that these incidents are taking place. I'm also aware from intelligence, from very, very reliable reports, that some ballot papers also arrested at OP yesterday in the night. These reports have not been made available to the public. I know that there are arrests made. In Latvia, there have been arrests. In OP, we are told there have been arrests. That we are surprised that so far the police have not publicly executed the arrested ballot boxes and the people involved. I just hope that this will not be a case of a cover-up, you know, in the course of the electoral process. I'm aware that in KFI, there is an attempt to deny four electoral wards ballot papers because they are not going to put in peace in KFI local government. We have been told that in many places across the state, there's the issue of reduction of straight voters and then send those ballot papers somewhere to store. We know that they want the election in Latvia to go into the night and up to tomorrow. You will notice that last week in the presidential election, voting went on interminably in Latvia. What were they doing? When they hear that results are coming from other areas, they will go and cook up more results, you know, from Latvia town. That is how they took the senior seat in Latvia territorial zone. That's how they also have attempted to take the House of Rep seat in that constituency. So they keep cooking up new people. So they refuse to vote. So they just keep away from voting and wait until the votes are returned from all other constituencies. Then they go and cook up and multiply the numbers to ensure that the top four people that have been legitimately elected. Now let me warn today that we will not accept any result emanating from rigged votes. President Jonathan has set the standard for this country.
Yes.
And we want to see that as he behaved, even though there are so many problems, we expect every incumbent governor to know that power belongs to God, does not belong to them. And that God can bring down one and lift another.
Yes.
So
yes,
there is no reason for anybody to think that because you sit in office, you use your authority to manipulate INEC, to manipulate police, to manipulate security agencies, to manipulate sometimes even the media, I'm told.
Yes.
So this kind of thing should not be allowed. So we are warning incumbents. The electoral process in Nigeria, as far as President Jonathan has done, must be like the electronic gadget at the airport, screening machine. You know? So you come there, you are screened in.
Okay. One more question.